Hello, welcome to this OHSU Library quick tip video on searching PubMed. This tutorial will take you through 5 steps for conducting a PubMed search. Step 1, begin by identifying the main concepts in your question. This will help you simplify and organize your search strategy. If you have a clinical question, you can use the PICO acronym to identify and separate its key concepts. PICO stands for Patient Population or Problem, Intervention, Comparison, and Outcome. For example, if you want to know if wildfire smoke causes asthma attacks in children, our main concepts would be children, wildfire smoke, and asthma attacks. Not all questions include a comparison. Our question, for example, does not compare wildfire smoke exposure to other factors. PICO is most commonly used for clinical questions. However, if you have a research, quality improvement, or another type of question, beginning by similarly identifying its key concepts is helpful. Step 2. Now we're ready to go to PubMed. We recommend accessing PubMed from the OHSU specific PubMed URL or from the library's homepage so you can easily access full text. Here we are on the library's homepage. Scroll down to the Databases tab on the left-hand side of the page to access PubMed. Step 3. It's time to search for each concept in your question individually using a combination of subject headings and keywords. This will make your search process more effective and efficient. Let's begin by typing in the first concept term, children, to the PubMed search box. Now let's see how PubMed interpreted the search. To look at the search results, click on Advanced. Then scroll down and click on the caret in the Details section. This shows how PubMed interpreted the search. PubMed will automatically look for a MeSH term for your concept. MeSH terms are designated words or phrases selected to represent a concept and allow you to locate articles which are specifically about that topic. Sometimes this automatic process succeeds and sometimes it doesn't. In this case, it looks like our search was successfully mapped to the MeSH term child and the keywords child or children. So part of our work is done. Next, let's create a search for the second concept, wildfire smoke. Another way of finding MeSH terms is by using the MeSH database. From the Advanced Search page, scroll down to the NCBI Literature Resources and click MeSH. You can also access MeSH from the PubMed homepage. Let's start by typing in the phrase wildfire smoke. As you can see, I'm not finding any matching MeSH terms. Let's try again using a different keyword. This time, I'll just use wildfire, which returns the MeSH term wildfires. To use this term in your search, click Add to Search Builder on the right of the screen, then search PubMed. But we won't stop there. Searching only with MeSH terms means that you won't retrieve some relevant articles. So it's important to combine your MeSH terms with keywords. For example, for my wildfire concept, I will want to include the keyword wildfire, its spelling variations, and other terms such as forest fire and bushfire. To do that, let's head to the Advanced Search page. Type in your keyword terms, then click Add to History. OR is used to combine terms when you want either term in your results, and it's good for combining keywords like we did here. Now you have 2 searches on wildfires. One that uses keywords and one that uses the MeSH term wildfires. Let's combine them to finalize our wildfire concept search. You can do this by clicking on the ellipsis in the action section of the searches you want to combine. First, click on the action ellipsis for the keyword wildfire search and choose Add to Query. Then, click on the action ellipsis for the wildfire's MeSH term search and choose Add with OR. Now let's search for the smoke part of our concept. As I did for child, I'm going to begin by doing a simple search on smoke and seeing how PubMed interprets it. But this time, I'm starting on the advanced search page. In the query box, type in smoke and click Add to History. Now let's see how PubMed interpreted our search. As before, click on the caret in the Details section to see how PubMed interpreted our search. As you can see, PubMed is searching on the MeSH term smoke and various keyword variations, so I'm happy with that. For our final concept search on asthma, let's return to the MeSH database. When I click on the MeSH link for asthma and scroll to the bottom of the page, you can see that there are a number of specific types of asthma listed under the main term. When we select our main asthma term and add it to the search builder, all those terms below it will be included in our search automatically. As before, let's also do a quick keyword search on asthma and use OR to combine it with our MeSH term. Now that we have searched each element or concept in our question individually, it's time to proceed to step 4, combining our concept sets with AND. Before we do that, let's briefly discuss combining search terms or sets with ORs and ANDs. OR is used when you want either term or concept in your results. AND is used when you want all the search terms or concepts in your results. We've already used OR to combine synonyms and MeSH terms. Now we'll use AND to combine the individual concept searches because we are looking for articles that address all of our concepts. First, let's add the children search to the query box. Next, click on the action ellipsis for the combined wildfire search and choose Add with AND. Then do the same for the smoke and asthma searches. All of our concepts now appear in the query box combined with AND, so let's complete our search. This brings us to our fifth and final step, using filters at the end of your search. This can help you focus on the articles most relevant to your question. The filters are located on the left side of the results page. As an example, we could try filtering our results by article type. To see all of the available options, click on Additional Filters. Please note, we don't recommend using any of the text availability filters, as these do not accurately reflect the content available to you through the OHSU library. We hope you found this OHSU library quick tips video helpful. If you have questions or would like to schedule a consultation with an OHSU library expert, please visit our contact page.